Hello, Michelle. Thank you for accepting our request to give this very special interview for Toastface YouTube channel. First of all, welcome to Marmaris Rally Turkey and our country. I would like to ask a question about your career. How did you start your rallying career, and why did you choose rally beside other sports?
I could say briefly that I didn't choose rally. Rally chose me. Because, I took... I have just the opportunity to be in a rally car with a friend of mine as a co-driver. And after a few rallies, my father thought it was better to try myself. So he proposed me to buy a car and to try. And of course, I accepted it. And from then, I went on and to the way you know about.
Then I'd like to ask a question about the way I know. You have four WRC victories to your name, which might be a bit special than the others. Can you please tell us?
Yeah, of course. I think, every time the first one, of course, is very important, because when you can win once, you believe that you can win more. And it's what happened. And so San Remo in 81 was a big time, a big day. Yeah, it's a special memory for me.
Okay. And have you ever competed against another female driver, maybe Britain's Louise Aitken Walker? Do you remember?
Yes, of course, I remember Louise very well. Louise was very fast, but unfortunately, we were not on the same cars, on the same level. So it's always this problem, for women. It's very often I had the chance to have the same car as the best driver in the World Championship. And when I was in France on the national level, I was also in a team with the best driver and the same car. So it pushed my motivation. It pushed myself to go to the limit, to be reaching the same level as men.
And now I'd like to ask a few questions about your involvement in the sport after your retirement from the rally stages. We know that you became an inspiration for many young female drivers, and how it feels to encourage them to be on the stages, to be in the circuits.
Yeah, I mean, for me, it's very, very simple. Nothing is impossible. If you want it, if you have the possibility, it's always a question of ability and possibility. But if you have the motivation and if you want something, nothing is impossible.
All right. And it's not the only thing that you made as a contribution to the sport and the development of the sport. You also became a co-organizer of the Race of Champions. Yeah. And you even encourage many spectators to watch this action, so you still keep doing things for the sport. How it feels?
Yeah, I mean, we were, Race of Champions was a race, to show on television what could be rallying, because it was a representation at the beginning of rallying. And of course, I mean, you feel happy when you see after nearly 30 years, because I started when my daughter was born, so it's a Race of Champions is more than 30 years now. It's a fantastic result to see that it's still going on and very successful.
Yeah, as you mentioned about your daughter, and as we mentioned about female drivers and the spectators, there is one more thing. Has your daughter ever competed in a motorsport event?
No, my daughter never wanted. She's smart enough. She never wanted to do like her mother. She wanted to do her own. And but also, I have to say, I never push her. She never asked, and I never proposed to her. So, I mean, it's she had other view on in life, and she's very happy. And now I will be grandmother very soon, so I am very, very happy.
Yeah, we are happy to hear those good news. One other thing you did for the sport is pushing the limits for a safer environment for all by joining the FIA Rally Commission. Can you please tell us about your role at the FIA and all those things you do for the improving the safety of the stages for all?
Yeah, for FIA, I work quite a lot. First, as a president of the Commission Women in Motorsport, that we are, pushing, and we have now a big project, a urban project for selection of girls all around Europe. So it's our next challenge. And then, of course, the most important is also that since 2 years now, I am responsible for safety in rallying. It's something that I am really particularly proud of, because, you know, it's a huge challenge, and working with all the organizers is really exciting. And together we can manage to have safe rally, and it's a lot of work, but very exciting and very interesting.
It's really very great to benefit from your knowledge, your experience. So you are just transforming your know-how to new organizers and already existing organizers.
Yeah, and I just want to also add that, you know, first of all, safety is priority number one for FIA. And also, you know, if we are not careful, I mean, our sport is a dangerous sport, so we want people to be safe all the time for the continuation of our sport, because it's very important.
And today you have been to the shakedown of Marmaris Rally Turkey. So what was your first impression? How do you see the preparations? Is it a promising candidate event?
Yeah, it was very promising, and it was very well prepared. The stage was very nice, very representative of what I have seen this morning in the stages, and good preparation and everything. All the marshal doing the sign, and the communication was very good. And so, looking forward to this weekend.
Okay, and your last words. Do you have any message to rally fans or young talents?
You know, in life, I mean, life is very short. Do what you like, and if you like it, do it full speed and maximum for maximum results. So, like I said before, nothing is impossible if you want it.
Thank you very much once
Pleasure.
Again.
Pleasure. Thank you. Thank you very much.